हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय सेकेंड लेक्चर ऑफ जेनेटिक्स ऑन सर्च ऑफ जेनेटिक मटेरियल. इज इट डीएनए और आरएनए और प्रोटीन. इन माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर ग्रिफिथ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एक्सपेरिमेंट इन 1928 आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड दैट देयर was a substance. Please follow my previous class and link will be provided in the description box. First go through that lecture, and after that lecture you may come here, you may come to this second lecture. It will be easier for you to look this experiment after that discussion. From the Griffith experiment, Griffith has concluded that there is a substance, there is an agent which is responsible for transforming the non-virulent R2 bacteria into virulent form, and he called that agent as transforming principle. After 1928, from that experiment is not clearly fully understood from that principle. After that, after a long time back in 1930, a few research had been done, and in 1930 to 1940s, within these time interval, Avery and co-workers, the name is given here, Avery, MacLeod and McCarthy experiment from 1930 to 1940, long time interval. Full name of Avery, Oswald T. Avery, MacLeod, Colin M. MacLeod and MacLean McCarthy. They worked in Rockefeller Institute. If you cannot memorize all, you simply call this experiment as Avery and co-workers experiment, as it is very important. Avery and co-workers, Avery, MacLeod, McCarthy experiment, they have started from that point, and they had studied the biochemical nature of that extract. For this purpose, Griffith called that agent transforming principle. Identify that transforming principle, Avery, MacLeod and McCarthy, see the transformation from R2 to S3, means non-virulent to virulent type, in test tube, and they tested the biochemical nature and want to explain it biochemically. Its purpose, they had grown the 3S type of bacteria. 3S cells, detergent treatment to lysis the cell, and they found broken cells. Then the broken cells are centrifuged. Two things are found: cell debris and cell extract. Then the cell extract, they are incubated with living 2R culture, and after that 3S colonies. What was the conclusion? The conclusion was, this cell extract contains transforming principle. Extract contains transforming principle. This transforming principle, I have written here in short form, and this transforming principle, this term was used by scientist Griffith to explain that unknown agent which is responsible for transforming the virulent 2R bacteria to virulent 3S type, which causes the mice die. Is genetic material from 3S transform to R to 3S. Some macromolecular components, macromolecular components in extract transforming principle responsible for this transformation from 2R to 3S. And what will be the macromolecular components? It may be polysaccharide, it may be protein, it may be RNA, it may be DNA. As I have already said, they used biochemical treatment means they use enzyme to break down all of these components. Enzyme treatments used for this treatment: deoxyribonuclease and protease. DNAs means it breaks down DNA. Break DNA, RNA, protein. Now let's see the observation. Mixture DNA's treatment plus live tumor, no growth, no growth mixture RNAs growth mixture protease growth. Only in this case where DNA is used, DNA means deoxyribonuclease, this enzyme can break down DNA. Okay, so here DNA is absent, so no growth is observed. DNA is dead here, DNA is not present here, DNA is lies here, so no growth is observed. And here RNA means there is no RNA, but here DNA is present. Here RNA protein is present. RNA is present and protein is present. Here DNA is present, protein is present, and here DNA is present and RNA is present. Only this case where DNA is absent, here DNA is absent. here DNA is absent and no growth is present here, no growth is found here. So from this observation, this biochemical enzymatic treatment, they can easily conclude that in that transforming principle which was found in cell extract, an unknown agent which was responsible for transforming the living non-virulent tumor bacteria to 3S bacteria, that was nothing but no RNA, no protein, but that was DNA. So from this experiment, Avery, MacLeod and McCarty, the Griffith observation, which was in a question and not easily explainable, there was a lot of question mark there at time. The experiment of Avery, MacLeod and McCarty for a long time gap from 1930s to 1940s gave a nice explanation, and it was second time it was proved successfully by enzymatic treatment that DNA is genetic material. Still, not that all scientific community was going to believe this, as all of this procedure, it is 1930 to 40. So not all the purifications process, not all the process was so pure, and the scientific community was not going to accept fully on this explanation. So for further explanation, this experiment was done by in 1953, Hershey and Chase experiment, which will be discussed in my next class. So keep in touch.